Low tide, double up. The low tide made movement round the harbour too difficult. Only 10 cents top hat and warrior were working in the harbour itself. The other tugs are busy helping Percy and Thomas with the mail. 10 cents and top hat had just arrived back at the small engine dock pier when an urgent message arrived for me. A large holiday boat was having engine trouble and needed to be brought into the harbour. I called 10 cents and top hat over. You two, I have an urgent job for you to do. You're needed to bring in the holiday ship called the Spirit of Tasmania. It can't manage, but it can with your help. Watch out for the tide. defeated the father beats you, so don't waste any time. Right, Captain Cox says, it takes sense. He's meaning low tide. What beats us if we don't work faster, Petrus? Tensions. I wouldn't like to get stuck in a dry dock that looks like a pigsty. They set off to find the spirit of Tasmania. They were glad Zarin was not with us anymore. You see, he was banished a long time ago, and only stuck in an American museum, never to come back. 10 cents is glad I banished him because Captain Star warned me about him being a nuisance with his mocks and tricks. They found the big ship. None of the Star Chugs ever heard about the spirit of Tasmania for years, let alone not tow in one. They hitched their ropes on and began to tow him in, but the tide was running strongly. This wasn't what they wanted when they had to work fast. They kept trying, but it was no use. Come on, Tensions. More power. I'm already on full power, Tophead. This isn't working. We need a hand. But a whistle was heard from them. Need a hand, guys. Said Mario, positioning himself behind the big ship. They managed to get her docked from the thief then. That evening I came to see them. Well done. I'm proud of how you all performed. A team strength to move the new ship. You haven't seen. I can say the same word like your captain said. You stars can be the best of something. This won't be told to Zarin now that he's banished from me. The Tugs had to agree. They were glad Zarin was stuck in the American Museum for mocking sunshine.